first historical mention of the possible presence in the soil of microscopic organisms, which may directly influence the life of man, is usually credited to a Roman writer, who said that swamps give rise to minute animals, which infect the air and cause human diseases. Actual observations of the presence of microorganisms in the soil were reported in 1671 by Anastasius Kirchius, who wrote that the air, water and soil are inhabited with numerous insects is so certain that it can be recognized with the naked eye. It was also known that worms are formed on putrefying bodies, but only since the wonderful discovery of the microscope has it become recognized that all rotting bodies swarm with a numerous mass of worms not recognized with the naked eye. This report was soon followed by the classical studies of van Leeuwenhoek, the father of bacteriology, who used his now famous microscope to examine various materials for the presence of animalculus. These were found in rainwater, in scum on teeth, and on other materials. The next 100 years brought forth various investigations of bacteria and other microorganisms found in nature. But these studies dealt primarily with the development of the microscope, with the determination of the size and shape of bacteria, and with attempts at rudimentary classification. The activities of the organisms and their role in natural processes either were not mentioned at all, or were merely a subject for speculation, although the important relation of the lower organisms to the higher forms of life, namely plants and animals, was gradually established. Here it is sufficient to refer to in this connection to the detailed knowledge that existed concerning the production of nitrates in soils and in composts. By the middle of the last century, it was definitely established that stable manure becomes a nutrient to plants only after it has undergone a period of decomposition or fermentation. Although the exact nature of this process was hardly understood, the beginning of our systematic knowledge of soil microorganisms had to wait until the birth of general systematic bacteriology. In 1836 up till 1839, several distinct contributions appeared which had an indirect bearing upon knowledge of the activities of the microbial population of the soil. These were the first careful studies on the role of microorganisms in the decomposition of organic matter, and of course in the formation of alcohols and acids. Organic matter decomposition was known to give rise to humus, which was believed to be one of the fundamental factors in soil fertility. The use of legumes for enrichment of the soil was known to the ancient Romans. Berthelot was the first to suggest that nitrogen fixation may be accomplished also by non-symbiotic bacteria. The accumulation of nitrates in the soil as a result of decomposition of organic matter was known in the 70s and 80s centuries, but only Boussingault and Sluising connected this process with soil fertility. Thus began a series of studies on nitrification, which was to have an important effect upon the knowledge of soil microbiological processes. The production of ammonia and the liberation of heat are now recognized to be the important phases of protein decomposition and of energy transformation by microorganisms. Written by Professor Selman A. Waksman, Professor of Microbiology, Rutgers University, in about 1938.